I want to not exist, fade away into the background filled with nameless faces and painted movie sets. I want to stop breathing, stop myself from taking in oxygen filled with hope. I wish my body would learn to stop trying to revive expectations of being anything more than a beaten mic in the corner of the lounge. I want to stop living. I want to give my wasted predications to less fortunate subjects who look at their objectives more positively. Give them chances in life that I don't deserve. I need to start the bleeding. I want to remember the feeling of blood trickling down self-medicated wounds. Bathtubs filled with salty water to mutilate cuts from razors built from shattered poems. I want to burn it into my skin. I want the scent of flesh singed from pages of unfinished bibliographies of unspoken words. I want to feel each word on my aflame skin. I want to know how it is to become one with burnt out thoughts. I want to give up, find a rope, and let transgressions hang for all to see. Find the key to the roof and count how many stanzas I can create before gravity plays tragic antagonist in the story of an ill-minded young man. I want to remember the euphoric feeling you get right before you become prisoner to your mind. I want to remember how it is to dream and never wake up again. I want to die, become just a memory of a poet who never made it. I want to be forgotten in the hearts of those who know me. Be just a verse that once was. I want to be a forgotten syllable. I want to be the lost poetry that decayed. Whoa. I'm kind of going to do like a 180 from that poem. Fight or flight. The primitive rationality every living being has to stand its ground or leave it be. My godson, all of nine, told me anytime he sees boys in blue, he cringes. He said, "Uncle, uncle, can you take me to school tomorrow? They can't hurt me if you're around." It enrages me that he is not yet double digits and already that he knows that there are targets on boys with melanin in their skin as if they were glorified game cattle. My oldest nephew, skin darker than dying stars, was stopped by the cops while shooting hoops after school. Told him boys his skin tone only run down courts to pass the time when dribbling double lives. He's now afraid to run between court lines, knowing that it is suicide to step out on these streets for the lineage of strange fruit. They want to control us with fear, holding their sense of power over our heads. It's a pendulum swaying in the wind like seven toes. They hope that their gold badges will scare us like frantic chicken, forgetting our men standing tall like roosters. So they scratch trigger fingers, pulling burners out to make deep-fried foul play. So if Animal Farm taught us anything, it's to never trust pigs who stand on two legs for supremacy. They pull our history from out our backs, filling our spinal cavity with false fabricated truth. So our youth learn from their environment instead. So how can you expect them to participate in class when the streets have taught them that raising their hands and speaking when spoken to gets them charged with execution via bullets who not know your identity or goal? And how can you tell them to reach for the stars when standing in grounds alone to be gunned down before you can even have your snacks? I am not condoning delinquency, but until these officers learn to drop knowledge over colored boys' bodies, society will continue to have this perpetual chain wrapped around its neck. And this piece isn't for my mic boys, the color brown, being served with a side of shot then question. No, this isn't for my color folks being picked on like hors d'oeuvres tray on. I mean, on tray. This is for Darren Hunt, who was shot down for cosplaying on Utah streets. His samurai shampoo apparently didn't protect him from copper hollow tips. This is for Mr. Crawford, who was executed in Walmart for plastic dyed black. Looks like we need a major cleaning in our USA. So this is my manifesto, manifesting my question to you. How many dead fruits must we as people consume before our stomachs pull out bow made from a lack of action? Leave your hashtags at the door and raise your articulate weapons in the air until they hear the roar of every sound bell ringing in their ears. Let's recall the passion for justice we as people had in riots of LA and collided with the simpleness of Ferguson, so our children will never have to be afraid to be hunted down again. This is me choosing to fight fear with bullets, with bulletproof made out of conjugations, and I'm equipped with figurative hand grenades, and I'm launching them at them till I explode humanity into every law enforcement agent. This is me stressing my right to fight over dying on her tonight. We all know the saying, don't cry over spilled milk, but in my family, we were taught to never cry over spilled blood. I was raised knowing that it is kill or be killed before night broke. I realized I could die at any time, so I walked around having death living in my eyes. I had the scent of the afterlife seeping from my pores. So by the time I reached freshman year of high school, coyotes did not bother to attack me, and vultures seem to always fly around me. Thank you.